Okay. Now let us talk about, since we are talking about magnetic field lines property, let me talk about flux, magnetic flux. Write down. Magnetic flux. Okay. Now, if I take enclosure, if I take an enclosure, just like I take for Gauss law, like 3D enclosure. Okay. So if I take an enclosure like this, how much do you think magnetic flux should be? How much it should be? First of all, magnetic flux is a measure of what? Can you type in what does it measure? Measure of what? What magnetic flux means? Okay, tell me what. Correct. Just like electric flux is number of electric field lines. Okay. Passing through an area. Similarly, magnetic field is proportional to number of magnetic lines, magnetic field lines that are passing through an area. Okay. Now, if I take an area in such a way that it is an enclosure, okay? If it is an enclosure, okay, and inside the enclosure you have total charge of plus Q, then what will be the electric flux equals to? Electric flux is Q by epsilon naught. This is what Gauss law has told us, isn't it? Now, can I find out what is the magnetic flux through an enclosure? Electric flux through an enclosure is how much is the charge enclosed divided by epsilon naught. Now, what is the value of magnetic flux through an 3D enclosure? That is equal to what? Can you guess? It will be zero. Okay. Magnetic flux through an enclosure is always zero. Okay. Why? What is the reason for this? What do you think is the reason for this? If you try to understand in terms of the, you know, in terms of correlating the situation with the Gauss law, if you try to correlate, you know, there is no analog of a single charge in magnetic field, but then there is an analog of a dipole. So if you enclose plus Q and minus Q, that is equivalent to enclosing a bar magnet, let's say north and south pole. Okay. So if you enclose both plus Q and minus Q, which is a dipole, electric flux will be zero because Q enclosed will be zero. Similarly, it happens here. You cannot enclose just north pole or south pole. You have to enclose both. So if you enclose both, then the flux should be equal to zero. Okay. So that is one way of understanding. Okay. Second way of understanding is that suppose magnetic field lines get generated from the north pole. Okay. It get generated. So one field line goes outside the enclosure, but then one field line will come inside the south pole also. Okay. So net net, the number of field lines that are going away from this enclosure is zero because one goes out and one comes in. So net net, it is zero. If you enclose a bar magnet like this, fine. The strength of north pole will be exactly equal to the strength of south pole whenever they both exist. Okay. So that is a number of field line going from the North Pole will always be equal to number of field lines that are coming towards the South Pole. That is one. Another way to understand, suppose you do not enclose any magnet inside. If you do not enclose any magnet inside, then magnetic field line, since they are forming a loop, will go in and will come out. Okay, it will be like this. So it goes in, magnetic field line, it has to form a loop. So that is why if it goes in, it has to come out, as there is no pole. There is no poles inside. Had there been a south pole, this field line would have captured by the south pole. But then since there is no magnet inside, that is why the whatever field line goes in has to come out, since it has to form a loop. So in all cases, the total flux inside a 3D enclosure will be always zero. Okay, but then you remember that there is a magnetic flux we discussed in previous chapter through an area. Okay, like in magnetic induction, what we have found out, EMF is rate of change of magnetic flux. Okay, with a negative sign over here. How come this is there? We have just proved that magnetic flux should be zero. So if it is zero, then phi b is zero. So rate of change of phi b should also be zero, because it is zero. It is a constant. So how come d phi by dt is non-zero? Any answer? See, flux through an enclosure is zero. Okay, but when we find EMF, we find flux through what? Through a loop. Okay, flux through a loop is different from flux through an enclosure. Enclosure is 3D enclosure. It covers entire volume. But if you have a loop, it could be just a two-dimensional thing like this. Okay, so if it is like that, net flux need not be zero. Magnetic field could come from below and move up like this. Okay, so net flux is not zero now. But if you have a sphere, okay, which is a 3D enclosure, net flux is zero. Okay, so it's not that it is a generic rule that flux, magnetic flux should always be zero. No, magnetic flux through an enclosure is zero. Magnetic flux through a loop is simply B dot dA integral. And we have done it in a great detail. Okay, so this was the magnetic flux, and rate of change of this through a loop is EMF. Fine. So do not confuse the flux in a loop with flux through an enclosure. Okay, now till now we have been talking about magnetic field due to a bar magnet in a very qualitative manner. We have not yet introduced any mathematical relation or anything that has to do with calculation of magnetic field due to a bar magnet. Okay, so let us try to see how we can derive the equation for magnetic field due to a bar magnet. Okay, so what I'm trying to do here is that I'm saying bar magnet is equivalent to a solenoid. Why I'm saying so? You can just visualize a solenoid, how it is. You have a solenoid. Let us say a solenoid is this. Okay, I can just draw a small cylinder, and say that consider it as a solenoid. So let's take this as a solenoid. Okay, can you imagine field on this? imagine it is wrapped around like this, you know, it is wrapped. It's a solenoid, current is flowing like this, number of turns per unit length is n, okay? Can you try to draw the magnetic field lines because of solenoid? Just imagine, we have already done this. Remember that. You'll see that magnetic field line inside the solenoid will be, you know, like this. It tends to be straight, isn't it? It will be like this. Okay. And if it is an ideal solenoid, you know, if it is an ideal solenoid, then inside the solenoid, magnetic field lines will be uniform. Magnetic field lines per unit area inside the solenoid will be constant, and magnetic field will be a constant inside if it is a perfect solenoid. And outside the solenoid, magnetic field line will be zero. Okay, but when we say that magnetic field line in outside the solenoid is zero, okay, we are assuming that the length of the solenoid goes on and on. Okay, but that is not the actual case. We take a fixed length of cylinder here, and you'll see that magnetic field line will take a turn like this, you know, and form a loop like that. All of you understanding this? Any doubt on this particular thing? Feel free to message. Go in like this. Okay, so this is how magnetic field lines will be, as if here is the North Pole. This is the North Pole, and as if this is a South Pole. Are you getting it? So you'll see that magnetic field lines of a solenoid, of a finite solenoid, is similar to magnetic field line due to a bar magnet. Write down the field lines due to solenoid is similar to that of bar magnet. Okay, so since the situation is analogous with respect to field lines, and ultimately the magnetic field is determined by how the field lines are arranged, because the magnetic field is consequence of exactly how the field line is and what is the density of field line. Okay, so that is what determines magnetic field at any point in time or at any point in the space. Okay, so I can say here that these two are analogous. Okay, and what is a basic quantity in the magnetic field? In the magnetic field, dipole, or to be more precise, I can write down magnetic dipole. Fine, so magnetic dipole is something which connects this scenario with that scenario. Why I'm saying so? Because since field lines are similar, and if I say that this solenoid has magnetic dipole moment M, okay, if this solenoid has magnetic dipole M, and at a distance x, if its magnetic field is B, then if I take a bar magnet, if I take a bar magnet of same dipole moment, will it have same magnetic field at that location or not? Yes or no? Right? So, you know, it's like this. You take two electrons, okay? You take two electrons and the electric field due to those two electrons, if the magnitude of that is E, okay? And rather than taking two electrons, what you do, you take helium plus two, okay? If you take helium plus two, or just to make sure that, or you take any atom with minus two charge, okay? Let's not try to equate positive and negative ones. Take two electron and take a non-metal with minus two charge in it. They will both have same electric field, because electric field depends on what is the charge, how much is the charge, and how it is distributed. So both the cases, you take two electrons or a full atom with minus two charge, both are equivalent to minus two charge, minus two electron charge, which is a point charge. Okay, they are equivalent. Similarly here, okay, similarly here, you have a bar magnet and a solenoid. Okay, they both will have the same magnetic field if they both have same magnetic dipole moment. Fine, because magnetic dipole moment is the most basic element in the magnetic field. All right, right. So without further ado, let us now try to find out the magnetic field due to a solenoid in terms of magnetic dipole moment, right? So I am now trying to find magnetic field B as a function of magnetic dipole moment, okay? So that when I get the magnetic field as a function of magnetic dipole moment, then it doesn't matter whether there is a solenoid or a piece of bar magnet. If bar magnet has a dipole moment M, I'll use the same function and put the value of magnetic dipole moment there to get the magnetic field. Okay.